Celebrating the 70th birthday anniversary, and there was a colloquium given for him. And he said, God doesn't play dice with the universe.
No, he just plays hide and seek.
Learn to write screenplays, television scripts, plays, novels, and
Jesus, they're so full of it, you know? You can't teach writing. It's not something you can teach. You know, you can only expose the students to good literature and hope it inspires them. The ones that can write when they come to my class, and the others never learn.
You lose patience if the student isn't Dostoevsky or Joyce.
No, that isn't true. That's crazy. You know, what makes it worth it is that every now and then you get a gifted pupil. You know, there's this young girl in my class who wrote a fabulous short story called Oral Sex in the Age of Deconstruction, and it's full of insights and romantic and...
There they are.
I'm guaranteed Jack is going to want to take us for Chinese food again.
I think Sally's getting a little tired of our pasta places.
Hi. Is it supposed to rain?
Hi.
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 Hi. You took your coat. I opened some cold white wine.
Was it out there on the highway?
No, they're... Doing something Jack? 80th. They're always doing something
Jack,
80th.
You want
oh,
some?
Yeah.
I'm sick of it. You
I
want
know,
some
it's
cold
really,
white wine?
Yeah. Every time I go up to your place, it's running. So, it's a Chinese restaurant, right? I can't talk into the Italian restaurant, right? There's
let's
no chance.
It. Let's don't get crazy.
Now, before we go out to dinner, we want to tell you something.
Are you
I'm
going to
get a drink
myself.
She can.
What?
What do you want to?
No, go ahead.
What?
No, somebody tell us.
No, go ahead.
Jack and I are splitting up.
Oh, I see. It's just nothing serious.
What?
So
hey, we've discussed this for a long, long time, and we both think it's for the best. Okay?
You are joking, of course. This is a joke.
Don't do me a favor. Don't make a big deal out of it, okay? Because we're both fine.
Are you
we're okay.
Serious?
No, we're fine. We're fine.
Yeah, no. We both discussed it.
It's what do you mean?
Hey. I got a great idea. Let's go talk about this at dinner. This is going to turn into a bad thing.
I'm not going out to dinner.
Since when has this been decided? What are we talking about here? She's right.
It's something we've discussed for a while now.
Don't be worried. There's no hostility. Nobody's angry here. You see, we're fine.
What is the reason?
Don't turn it into a tragedy.
It's not our
guys, please, don't turn this into a tragedy, okay? Because it's a very positive step for both of us.
How can you get it, break up? That's insane. You're Jack and Sally. You got two kids.
Hey, our kids are grown up, for Christ's sake, you know? They're in college.
We don't want to bore you with the details.
I just can't get my mind around this. Since when? You guys get along so well.
She's right.
I mean, what, have you met other people? I mean, what?
Gabe, that isn't our business
I'm
at all.
I'm fascinated by this.
I just feel sick.
Hey, we didn't want to ruin anything, okay? We want to see what it's like to be apart. Yeah.
You know, don't not support us. We've finally gotten the nerve to do this thing.
This is total insanity. You'll be back together in one
week. She's going to keep the place in Riverdale, and I'm looking for a place in town.
Oh, I just feel shattered.
Oh, come on.
I do.
Let's eat.
What do you mean, come on, let's eat? Come on, I can't eat.
Well, don't get angry.
I'm not angry. I'm not angry. I'm not. You march in here and announce you're breaking up? You have two kids together. Why are you doing this? Why are you doing this?
This is not our business.
Why isn't it our business? They're our closest friends.
Hey, you're looking for one little answer? There is no one traumatic event. You know that. People grow apart. It's a lot of little personal things. Now stop it.
This is bullshit. This is just bullshit.
What's she so upset for?
Judy, what?
She cares about it.
I care about you, too.
Hey, Judy, we're fine, okay? Judy, we want to do this.
This is crazy. Judy, what are you taking this so personally for?
I'm upset, all right? Can I be upset?
Yep, you know.
Judy, you know, I've discussed this with a therapist.
You right.
have? You never said a word.
You said this was none of our business. What is her
business? Oh, no, we're all so close. I assumed we were.
She's upset.
Hey, will you guys please not turn this into a wake?
You know, why is this such a personal thing for you? I don't know what to
Look,
say.
Let's just go out to dinner.
Yeah, come on.
And, you know,
God.
Forget it.
Judy, this would turn into a whole big thing with your Sturm und Drang. I mean,
So why were you so upset?
I don't know. I really don't know.
It was a total shock?
Yeah, completely. You know, they were so casual about it. They didn't seem to be appropriately upset.
Were you hurt because Sally never mentioned anything to you?
Well, I think, you know, if I really look hard, you know, searching over the time when we were alone together, I think she may have made an occasional remark about, you know, just wondering what it would be like to be single now with all she knew, all she'd experienced, that kind of thing. But she never said anything negative at all about Jack, you know.
Listen, before we go on, just tell us something about yourself, so we know who you are.
Okay, so my name is Judy Roth. I'm married to Gabe. We've been married about 10 years. I work for an art magazine. We don't have any children. I do have a daughter from a previous marriage. I was married when I was very young to, excuse me, to an architect, and it just didn't work out. It's nobody's fault.
Judy told us that she did finally go out to dinner that night. She said she was tense and nervous, although the others seemed fine. After dinner, they walked home from the restaurant together, and while she tried her best to participate, she found the atmosphere strained. All in all, she said, for her, it was a very peculiar evening.
Amazing, isn't it? You know, you think you're so friendly with people and so close, and then it turns out that you really have no idea what they're thinking.
Do you ever hide things from me?
Me? What kind of things?
Feelings, you know. Longings, complaints.
No. Do you?
No. Sometimes, maybe.
Really? Like what?
I don't know. You know how you're always so critical. We've had this conversation.
You know, you are definitely in a strange mood tonight.
I'm fine. I'm sorry. So Jack never gave you an inkling, huh? It's so strange. You guys are so close.
Actually, I do remember one incident he mentioned at his office.
Jack, you have to trust me on this. This girl is to die. Her name is Shawn Granger. She's built out to here. You will have the greatest time of your life. And for $200, believe me, it's a bargain.
Hey, I'm not going to sleep with a whore. What about AIDS?
She's not a streetwalker. She's a high-class call girl, and she will do anything you want. And on top of it, she's got friends.
I'm not going to do that to my wife, all right?
right? It's dangerous.
Look, who is the guy who told me that your sex life wasn't so terrific, right?
Oh, come on. At a two martini lunch, I'll say anything.
Sean has got a mouth like velvet, believe me. Just like velvet. She was a former Miss Something or other. She's got...
Listen, what exactly did I say at lunch?
You said that Sally was cold and you were dying to fuck your aerobics trainer.
I should never, ever drink at lunch.
Look, I'll tell you what. I'm going to write down the number, and I advise you to... I advise you to...
Hey, what are you...
Have I ever steered
you? Get out of here.
I have never steered you.
Get out of here.
All right, there it is. Use it.
He called me. I got the impression it was about a month or so after he got my number. He was very polite on the phone, a little tense. You know, I can always tell the ones who haven't had experience. He wanted me to meet him at the Americana Hotel. And when I got there, he was very polite, very gentlemanly, very nervous. He couldn't go through with the sex. He couldn't get it up. While I was there, he experienced some terrible pains in his chest, and I thought he was having a heart attack, but they passed.
And that was the last you saw of him?
No, he called me a couple months later. I met him at the same hotel. This time he slept with me. And then I started seeing him fairly regularly every 2-3 weeks. He said he'd seen a psychiatrist and worked out his problem. One time I couldn't make it, and I sent my girlfriend, and then he started seeing the both of us, you know, alternating. Then neither one of us ever saw him again.
So he never called her. At least he had the decency to throw the number away.
Well, to the best of my knowledge. But, you know, Jack is not a hooker guy. Jack is very straight-laced.
And Sally's cold in bed.
Sally's cold? Well, that shouldn't come as a surprise. She's very cerebral anyhow.
Am I cold in bed?
No. Why would you say that? Of course not.
But I am inhibited, right? I remember you said that yourself.
It's amazing. You can't forget that. We had one minor little argument years ago about that, in which you blew up into a major confrontation, and I can't get it off your mind.
Do you ever have the urge to sleep with a whore?
Me? No. Definitely not. Yeah. When I was in college, I did.
Yeah?
You're in an odd mood tonight. I can see it. You know, I think Jack and Sally's breakup has definitely affected you.
You think we'd ever break up?
What kind of question is that? You know, no, I'm not planning it, are you?
No.
Okay.
But I don't know how I'm going to feel if you continue to not want to make me pregnant.
Hey, are we going to have to go through that conversation again? You know, you have a daughter. What?
Yeah.
So she's a wonderful girl.
I want another.
Why? What is so important? Why? It's cruel to bring life into this terrible world, you know? It's not...
No, don't glorify your refusal on philosophical grounds.
What you know, if you could see the angry look in your face when you say that.
You want to make love?
Okay, but, if we can... You know, get into it in some way. I can't just do it on command.
We can get into it.
Just put your diaphragm on.
Okay.
Hey, you would never tell me you were putting your diaphragm on and then not do it, right?
What? What a thing to say. That's a terrible thing to say. My God, you really trust no one, do you? No wonder people accuse you of cynicism.
Okay, I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm tired. It's 1 o'clock in the morning.
Well, we don't have to do it. Are you still attracted to me?
Yes, I'm attracted to you.
It's true.
You know, yes,
because
I'm attracted to
we
you.
We do it less and less. You know?
Well, you know, our schedules are not exactly conducive.
Oh, that's just bullshit. You know, when we wanted to, we found time.
Hey, come here.
People's parties and other people's bathrooms,
come here.
Wherever.
Sit, relax for a minute, will you? If you remember clearly when we used to do that spontaneous sex, you were very, you know, you never really liked that. You were always tense. You always heard people in the next room eating or making noises in the dining room. Remember that? Now you remember it, you know, in a glorified way.
Are you ever attracted to other women?
Who? Like who?
Well, like all those women that you have in your class who are so talented and insightful. You know, I'm sure they totally worship you.
Can I tell you that they don't want an old man, all right?
I think an old man does better than an old woman.
Well, then we're definitely stuck with one another. Now, come on, you're really... Come on.
Sometime later, Sally had a dinner date with Paul, a colleague at work who had always liked her.
Sally, come on in.
Thank you very much.
Come into my rent-stabilized den. Can I take your coat?
Oh, it's lovely. I love it. Thank you.
Just, I thought we'd have a drink, and I was able to get some tickets to Don Giovanni.
Great, great.
You all right?
Yes, yes, I...
What would you like?
Anything. White wine?
White wine. Ooh. I hear the staging of this opera is not to be believed.
Oh, really? Oh, fabulous. Oh, that's lovely.
Oh! Oh! Oh, hey, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I'll get it later.
Can I use the phone?
Yes, yeah, sure. You all right?
Yes! Yes, I'm looking forward to it.
It's this way.
Here.
A good friend of mine did the sets.
Oh.
You want...
It's me. You're living with her, aren't you? You've moved in together. Don't lie to me, Jack. You're living with someone. Because I know. Because I do. Yes, I heard. Don't give me that shit. It's been 3 fucking weeks. How did you meet someone so fast? Oh, bullshit. You had to have known her before. Bullshit! Don't give me that shit! Oh, you're in love. So fast? I don't fucking believe it. You were seeing whoever it is all along. Well, of course I expected things to happen, but not so fast. Are you that sure? No, I'm not. Oh, God, it's just fucking dishonest bullshit.
Hi, you...
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Listen, if you're having some kind of personal thing...
Really? I'm okay. I'm looking forward to tonight. What are we seeing?
Don Giovanni.
A Don Juan story.
Oh, I can only think of it as Mozart.
Fucking Don Juans. They should have cut his fucking dick off.
Can I get you some more wine?
Please.
You know, we don't have to go.
No, no, no. I'm not going to put my life on hold. I've been dying to see this opera. Excuse me one second.
Sure.
Hello, me again. I know who she is. Bullshit, it's Gail. Of course it's Gail. She's been after you since she joined the firm. You two like that sports bullshit. Don't lie to me, Jack. Of course it's Gail. She's exactly what you like. She's got that dark look, and she's bright and all that fucking Princeton bullshit. No. No, no. I thought it was an experiment. I didn't think it was final. I didn't realize you were having an affair. Yeah, well, that's bullshit. I don't buy a fucking word of it. What time do we have to be there?
Listen, I don't really think I can do this. I'm feeling upset.
What are you upset about? Ooh. Fucking men. Woman gets to be over a certain age, it becomes a different ballgame.
Oh, no.
Don't defend your sex. It's true. You're great till you start to show your age. Then they want a newer model.
Sally, You're a very attractive woman. For any age.
It was a terrible blow to my ego. You know, I thought he loved me, that, that we were experimenting, you know?
But if you had met someone first?
Probably right. Probably would have done the same thing. I had fantasized about being single many times. You know, it's hard to keep a marriage going smoothly, you know. All the frustration and baggage. I don't know. Gail came to work in his office the year before, and I'd met her several times. Look, what can I say? She's cultivated, intelligent. It's what he likes. She'd been over to the house a few times. She loved my taste in everything. She even dressed like me a little. What can I say? She's me, but she's younger.
Yeah. Hey, listen, your short story was absolutely fabulous.
Really?
Yeah. I was very, very impressed, I must say. And I thought it was probably the best thing that I read this term. It was really wonderful.
Oh, it's great.
Yeah. The insights were great, and I thought the prose was very graceful. And, you know, in general, I was impressed.
Oh, God, I'm blushing, right?
Oh, well, don't. You know,
my face gets all red. Let me just cry.
Take it that. Actually, I meant it as a compliment.
No, I know.
It was great. The insights were wonderful.
Your approbation means more to me than anybody's. I mean, you're the reason why I wanted to start writing.
Really?
Yeah. My family and I, we used to quote, you know, the gray hat.
Oh, God, yeah. How do you remember that story?
Because giving up his hopes, compromising one's dreams is like putting on a gray hat. I love that. I mean,
you remember that. That's great.
Listen to me. You can hear my heart beating.
How'd you get the name Rain?
My parents named me after Rilke.
Did they?
Yeah, it's my mother's favorite poet. And so that's how I got it.
Are you folks, you know, writers or?
Oh, no. My dad's an investment banker and my mom works at Lincoln Center.
Are you an only child?
Why are you asking all these questions?
Well, I'm just interested. I was so impressed by the story. I gave it to someone else to read, and she was also very, very impressed with it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Are you from New York or?
Yeah, I'm from East End.
Have you so many questions?
No, it's fine. It's just the only child one. Yes, I was an only child. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So how did you manage to write something so deep? I mean, have you been married and divorced, or is your whole family stormy and tempestuous, or?
What? I didn't know I was stormy and tempestuous.
Well, the writing was very, you know, I found it very intense.
Yeah, it's just a trick, you know. It's like when I was 10, one time I wrote this whole story on Paris, and I'd never even been there, you know. So it's like, you don't have to, it's just a trick. You don't have to know. Or, yeah.
Can you just turn it out? I mean. There are a number of very, very good professors who are notorious for seducing their female pupils. This goes on, and because it's a cinch, you know, they look up to them, and they're, you know, they're older men, and their students are flattered by the attention. It's not something that I've ever done. I'm not saying that I haven't had daydreams in class at times, because some of those women are very attractive and very interesting, but I've never acted on it, and I've never cheated on Judy or any other relationship in my life, really, because that has not been my style. But once, many years ago, I was living with this fabulous, interesting woman named Harriet Harman, I'm ashamed to say this, but Harriet Harman remains was the great love of my life. You know, it was a very passionate relationship. You know, I loved her very, very intensely, and you know, we just made love everywhere. She was sexually carnivorous. You know, we did it in stalled elevators and in bushes and at people's houses at parties in the bathroom, and I hate to tell you, in the back of cars, she'd put coat on her laps and then suddenly grab my hand, stick it between her legs. I mean, she was really something, and she was highly libidinous. You know what I mean? She wanted to make love with other women, and she got into dope for a while. She would break that thing that you sniff when she'd have her orgasm, and you know, and I was getting a real education, and I was, you know, fascinated. I was just absolutely nuts about her, and you know, and ultimately she wound up in an institution. I mean, it's not funny. It was a very sad thing. She was, you know, great, but nuts. I've always had this penchant for what I call kamikaze women, because I call them kamikazes because they, you know, they crash their plane, they're self-destructive, but they crash it into you when you die along with them. As soon as there's a challenge, as soon as there's very little chance of it working out, or no chance, or there's going to be hurdles or obstacles, something clicks into my mind. Maybe that's because I'm a writer, but some dramatic or aesthetic component becomes right, and I go after that person, and there's a certain dramatic ambiance that it's almost as if I fall in love with the person, in love with the situation in some way, and of course it has not worked out well for me. It has not been great, and anyhow, a few weeks after Jack and Sally split, you know, he and I didn't speak much, and because I found him elusive at the time, and we spent much more time with Sally. And she was depressed, you know, and we try and cheer up all the time.
I would be scared, first of all, to live by myself where you live.
It's scary. You know? It's really scary. And there's been a series of burglaries. The house next door to mine was robbed. Really? And nearby, the people were at home.
Excuse me.
I mean, it's lucky for them I didn't wake up.
I would die. I don't think I'd never close my eyes at night if I had to. So you want to get something to eat or what?
Sure.
Hey.
Sam, this
Hi.
Is Sam.
Hi, how are you?
Steven,
how are you?
This is
Judy.
Hi.
Judy.
Well, look, I have to go. I'm sorry.
Oh, listen, we can all.
No, I have an appointment. I really do.
Really?
Don't be crazy.
No, I have an appointment.
Well,
I have to go.
I just wanted you guys. Coincidence, huh?
Oh, I know. Well, I didn't get your name before. You know,
Sam.
You know,
yeah.
Sam. Right. Sam. Okay, Sam. So you guys are just walking around out.
Yeah,
right?
We just had lunch.
What do you do?
Aerobics.
Great.
And I'm a trainer and
uh-huh.
some nutrition.
Uh-huh.
Hey, what are you guys doing later? You want to come and have dinner at the house? She's an unbelievable cook.
I am.
I don't think it's possible
well,
tonight.
It's totally vegetarian.
We can't tonight.
You know, you don't eat meat, do you?
No, I don't.
Sometimes. I used to eat red meat every day, and then I gave it up, and then I had some again recently, and I was totally bloated.
We can order out.
Like,
there's a little Mexican place around the corner if you don't like this.
Oh, yeah, I flip
on,
over couscous.
Like, you feel like cooking?
Whatever you
Let's
want.
Let's do it. Let's do it. Come on.
Yeah, I'm just going to stay in, watch the Grammys.
I can't. You're
watching the Grammys? She watches all these dumbass shows.
But chill over the best single.
I'm not watching the Grammys, okay? What are you doing?
My mother
yeah, his mother
is
going to be
in town,
gonna be
you know,
in town
so not,
for the whole
possible,
rest
know,
of the week.
Okay, well, you know, maybe later. I've been meaning to call.
I like to pick up some decaf.
Oh, yeah. There's a great store. I need some ginseng.
Okay.
She is really something. She is so great. You know, she's got a degree in psychology. Mm-hmm. She's really into this fitness. She is terrific. She's into this fitness thing. She's a nice girl. Her family's from Delaware. Her father's in police work.
I can't get my mind around this. This is what you leave Sally for?
Hey, be careful, man. I'm serious about her.
I mean, but you know, you're my friend. I love you. I mean, we've been friends for years. It's like your IQ is suddenly in remission.
Please,
you know, it's like,
please, what are you doing?
Don't give me some moralizing
discourse. You're not my rabbi.
I just can't believe it. You know, you're married to this woman for years. You raise a family. She's, you know, she's wonderful.
Yeah.
Or she's a ball breaker sometimes.
She's a ball breaker. You know. Hey, don't you give me that bullshit. I lived with her. You didn't. You don't know her.
I don't know her, no. So then tell me something terrible. This guy better be awfully incriminating.
I'm going to tell you something terrible. There's nothing terrible to tell you, okay? I care about her. She's great, all right? I don't want to hurt her. That's not what this is about.
Well, so and suddenly out of left field, you take up with a cocktail waitress, and I'm supposed to just be completely...
She is not a cocktail waitress.
You know,
she's
I'm thinking of you
girl.
And Sally.
She's terrific. She's warm, and she's nice, and I can relax around her. I can breathe. Sally was hyper. You know that. She's great, but she's cold, and she's difficult with
you're
her,
telling
with her
yourself
Radcliffe
this.
Friends and her all that crap about her interior decorator. Hey, you want to know something? I was bored at the opera. I was bored at the opera. She would never go to a Giants game with me. We would never just sit around and relax. If I put an ashtray down in the wrong place in the house,
right? So you took you 15 years to understand this,
okay,
right?
Okay, so I should have done it a long time ago. But you know, I mean, there were kids, and we're all scared of being alone. Hey, listen, I love Sally. Okay, don't get me wrong. What's wrong with aerobics? What am I, a snob? So she's not Simone de Beauvoir. She's a big deal. She's not Simone de Beauvoir. I want to enjoy the rest of my life, okay? I want somebody who digs her nails into my back and screams when I fuck her.
She's a fucking cocktail waitress.
Or at least moves.
She's a cocktail waitress.
Hey, stop it. That's not your business, man. You don't know what goes on between two people. I'm tired of being corrected and criticized. That's all I ever did with Sally. I was always auditioning. And your mother is not in town, Gabe. She's in Florida.
I really think no matter how hard we worked, the marriage wouldn't have lasted.
How long were you and Judy married?
5 years.
Why did you split up?
At the time, I thought I wanted out. I felt I had just run out of gas. But as I look back at it, I think it was really Judy who wanted out.
Oh, so she left you?
No, she'd never. That's not her style. Don't let Judy fool you. She's what I call passive-aggressive. Everything is poor me, give me a break, but she gets what she wants. I remember the day she met her current husband, Gabriel Roth.
Well, my husband's staying out here for the rest of the week with my daughter, but I have to take the train in tomorrow night. I have some business in town.
Oh, you know, let me give you a lift. I'm going to drive in tomorrow.
No, don't be silly. No,
why should you go on the train?
The train is fine.
It's
really.
Good day.
I was just going to get something to eat. Would you like something?
No. I'll get you something.
No, just on my way. Just tell me what you want.
Don't be silly. I'll get you something.
Constance, do you want anything else or anything to drink?
No, that'll be fine.
Just pass this out.
Yeah. And I can easily get a cab from Penn Station. No problem at all.
Don't be silly.
You see what I mean? He winds up getting the food. He changes his schedule. Drives her to her door. And all the time, it's no, I'll be okay, don't help me.
What my ex-husband doesn't say is that for the last 2 years of our marriage, he was virtually impotent when it came to me. He was just raging because I didn't turn out to be what he thought I'd be. He thought I'd be one thing, his mother, to be exact. And I couldn't take the fact that he was totally unromantic in every way. He was the kind of guy that gives you an appliance for your birthday.
I never got her a Meliere coffee maker for a birthday present. I got her a camera once and an enlarger for our anniversary, but she wanted it. She asked for it.
What are you thinking about?
I was just thinking about that manuscript you're reading.
Oh, geez, it's just a terrible novel. Terrible.
Very autobiographical.
What else am I going to work on?
Should I be insulted?
Why should you be insulted?
Your description of the way we met, that party in the Hamptons?
He spotted her from a distance, and Harriet leapt to mind. It was that simple. He was drawn to her instantly because she reminded him of his only genuine passion. His sixth sense told him to move on it. But she wasn't Harriet. The minute he met her, the dream evaporated.
Yeah, right. She wasn't crazy.
No, just boring.
Oh, no, she's the best woman in the book. That's why he marries her.
But he pays a price.
This is just junk anyhow. You know, I want to throw it away.
No, you're wrong. Listen, it's full of vitality and wit. It's good.
You're prejudiced because you're my wife.
Your dull wife. I don't know why you ask for my opinion ever. You know, you don't care about it.
It's not true.
It is true.
Mm-mm. You happen to think it's a mediocre novel. What
because
can I say?
You have no respect for my judgment. If somebody else came along and said that, you'd accept it totally.
I would not.
After a little time passed, Judy and Sally had lunch. Sally made a surprising announcement.
I like being single.
You do? I had the opposite impression.
Well, that's all anticipatory anxiety. Then you calm down, you realize it's not as bad as you fantasized. It's like pulling a bad tooth. All the festering wounds of your marriage, the disappointments, the resentments, they're gone in one clean yank, and you're free.
Boy.
You can't imagine, after years of accumulating problems and swallowing one's anger, to have the chance to begin again.
Yeah. I can't imagine.
The clock ticks faster for a woman. You have to do it while you still have some allure left. The one advantage of being a little older is you have a lot of experience.
Yeah.
I have a much better shot at making things work out.
I've often thought, you know, that if Gabe and I met now, knowing all the things we know, we'd have a better relationship, no question.
Would you still marry him?
God, what a question. You know, for me, the thought of breaking up is just so painful.
But you can't stay together out of fear, because then you know what you become?
What?
My mother and father.
Well, I've pictured myself free.
I know you have.
How do you know?
Because you got so angry that night when Jack and I said we were splitting. I thought about it later. I realized we must have touched a nerve.
No.
Yes, it's like Hamlet and Oedipus. You were angry that night because I did what you really want to do.
You're over-dramatizing. Gabe and I are okay. Nobody has it perfect.
I know. Listen, when it's good, nothing's better.
Listen, so I think maybe I have a possibility for you.
Tell me.
Michael Gates.
The one you said was attractive in your office?
He's only been there a few months. I know he had a girlfriend, but now they've broken up. I do think he's attractive. He's charming. He's bright. You know, the timing's perfect. What more could you want? You know? I just think if you come up to the office now and meet him and see how you feel. And if you think you're interested, we could all, I don't know, arrange something. We'll all go out together or something.
Michael, this is my friend Sally.
Hi, Sally.
Finding Hello. Some back issues for her. Sally's with the Landmarks Preservation Committee.
Oh, Preservation Committee. Well, I tell you something, I don't believe in capital punishment except for certain New York builders.
It's not just New York, though. There's always just a blind passion for the new, you know, the young.
Listen, you two wait here, and I'll go and Xerox those copies. I'll be right with you.
Fine.
Take a photo. Make yourself comfortable.
All right.
Throw it anywhere. Sorry about the clutter in here. We're in the middle of putting together a full issue of German furniture styles in the 20s and 30s.
I hate that period. I did my college thesis on Bauhaus architecture. It was called Function and Fascism. Uh-huh. This was years ago at Radcliffe, you know. I got so much flack on it. It was very unpopular. Not that it won't make a good magazine subject.
You have it well. Come on. Have a look at that chair. Do you remember that?
Yes,
isn't it wonderful?
I truly dislike that chair.
Okay, what about this chair?
I hated that chair.
So what do you think? Isn't he sweet?
Well, yes, he seems nice.
Yeah. I think he's sort of great looking, don't you?
And he's single and not gay.
Well, I'm telling you, he just broke up. I don't know him that well. You know, he's kind of quiet, but I like that about him. He's got a great sense of humor. He's a very charming drunk because there was somebody's birthday party up here and he had quite a lot of whiskey. And he was quoting Yeats poems and he was crying.
He was?
Yes.
He weeps.
But in the sweetest way. So what do you think? Shall I get us all together? Oh, you don't have to. He already has
asked me to lunch.
He did? Oh.
It came up that we both took courses at Cambridge. Uh-huh. We suggested we have lunch next week, so, you know.
That would be great. I'd be the matchmaker.
I took an instant liking for Sally. God, I was immediately attracted to her. She spoke her mind, she spoke her thoughts, which I really liked. And she's very sexy, you know. Now, look, I remember I wasn't looking for another relationship because I'd just split up with Amy and I'd sworn off getting involved. But with Sally, God, there was something that just hooked in at once.
So you were grateful to Judy for introducing you?
Yes, I was, very. It's funny, you know, when I first got to know Judy, I had the vague impression that she was flirting with me, you know? And I thought she must be unhappily married, you know. But I met her husband and they seemed fine. But that seems typical of Judy, you know, she's very giving and she did me this big favor by introducing me to Sally.
Your second story was every bit as interesting as your first. I just thought it was wonderful.
Oh, great.
I was knocked out by it, yeah.
I'm thrilled. I'm so glad you like it. You're so encouraging to me, you know. I want you to know that.
No, don't be silly. I'm just one opinion, you know, and I was impressed.
You're the opinion.
I thought your line was great about life doesn't imitate art, it imitates bad television, because I think it's completely true.
Right. I can't tell you how much your opinion means to me, you know?
No,
listen, you want to go for a walk? Or, I mean...
A walk?
You're busy, right?
No. Well,
I just meant for a walk, like, to discuss the...
Oh, you want to hear more about your story?
Yeah?
How good it is.
Well, I know...
You know, it was great, I thought. It was the way that you structured this story, because the tension built up so beautifully, and you released all the energy in the last paragraph. I thought it was very sophisticated.
Oh, thanks. I spent 5 days searching for the perfect word to describe the husband, and that's when I came up with Apuceus.
Apuceus, yeah. I looked that up in the dictionary, but I couldn't find it.
Yeah, I know. I made it up.
Oh, really?
I thought it described it perfectly.
Oh, Tolstoy is a full meal. Turgenev, I would say, is a fabulous dessert. That's how I characterize him.
And Dostoevsky?
Dostoevsky is a full meal with a vitamin pill and extra wheat germ.
I fall upon the thorns of life. I bleed. I used to think that was so romantic. Oh, to write, to fall in love, and to experience real passion.
Really? You think that passion could actually be sustained?
Oh, I don't know. Time magazine, they said you lose your sexual attraction for the other person in 4 years, I think it was.
Well,
time must know, right?
Yeah. I sometimes think of living in Paris, you know, or, you know, Europe in general. I just find that very romantic, you know, because I like cafe life. I would like to write, get maybe a small flat or something.
That sounds great.
Yeah, we're just walking the streets is fun in Paris, you know. Listen, let me tell you, until you've been kissed, one of those rainy Parisian afternoons, you've never been kissed, I promise you.
And were you kissed in the rain?
Well, I wasn't kissed, but I was the kisser.
Okay, I was wondering if I could read your novel.
How did I have another?
You mentioned it at lunch, when we had lunch that time.
You know, I'm very disenchanted with it. Really...
Yes, I know. And I'm only asking you because I think I could learn a lot from it, and I just would like to know what you like and what you don't like and why you're so critical of it, you know?
Let me think about it.
Woo!
Are you okay?
Yes.
Well, let me think about it. I'll think about it, you know? And...
Oh, I shouldn't have asked you.
No. Let me think about it.
Okay.
Hey, Gabe, he's always picked the wrong women, except for Judy. She's the first, you know, she's the first sane woman he ever fell for. He's always attracted to the crazies, the nutcases. You know? For some reason, I got a couple of theories about it. One is that, you know, deep down somewhere, he knows it's not going to work. And so he suffers. And that kind of atones for some sort of early on guilt he's got over what, I don't know. Another is, like, you know, all of us, he grew up on movies and novels where doomed love was romantic.
Well, what about you? How are things going with Sam?
Great. Absolutely great. You know, Saturday we got up, we had a run down by the river. It was a beautiful day. The light was great. You know, it was just terrific. I'm down to a good weight. She's got me exercising. It feels incredible to get in shape. I eat great. That's the other thing, you know. No salads, no meat, never touch meat. Later in the day, we rented some kind of a video. You know, it was some sort of dopey, funny, stupid little thing. Something Sally would have never let me bring in the house. And I want to tell you something. I laughed like hell. I had a terrific time. And I didn't have to feel guilty about it. Like I said, she's not Simone de Beauvoir. Okay, we argue sometimes.
Trust me on this, will you? It's Lear, King Lear. Shakespeare never wrote about a King Leo.
Well, Mr. Intellectual, Shakespeare wrote in English, not Japanese.
That's wonderful.
I was just going to make some cappuccino or something. You want some?
No.
You sure?
Positive, absolutely.
Listen, don't start getting all excited. I don't have my diaphragm
in. Jen, I don't want to make love to you without your diaphragm.
What are you talking about?
I'm serious. I was thinking about it, and I thought maybe I've been resisting having a child, you know, too strenuously.
What? Since when?
I don't know. I just was. These are just some thoughts that I've had. That's all. I thought maybe, you know, maybe it would be helpful in some way.
What kind of help did you have in mind?
I don't know.
Are you unhappy in our marriage?
I'll tell you, I don't think about it that much, you know, which is probably a good sign.
You know, it's late. I'm tired. Do you really want to talk about this now?
No, all I said was I thought it was a good idea to have a baby.
I don't think it's such a good idea.
Why? Why not, all of a sudden?
Because I think that we have some straightening out to do between us before we
have a baby. You wanted to have a baby. You know what? Why are you such a bad mood?
Do you want somebody new?
No. Who? Like who? I mean, do you?
I'm certainly not a baby.
Okay, so forget it. You know, I was bringing it up because I thought you wanted, you know.
Okay, fine.
In a bad mood or something you want to say to me and you're not saying.
No, I think we should be careful. We don't want to get into one of those kinds of things that you can't get out of.
So you don't want to have a baby, right? I mean, that's what I should...
You know I do.
Okay, so then we have to work on it, you know. But not tonight. Tonight, any thought of sex is now, you know...
I'm sorry.
Well, not your fault. I mean, this is crazy. I'm begging to have a baby that I don't even want.
Yeah, I knew you didn't want it.
I don't mean it that way. You know, I mean it differently. It's late and I'm confused. You know, we have a perfectly fine marriage. I don't know what all this talk is suddenly about.
Excuse me, Michael?
Mm-hmm.
I brought you a wonton soup since you were too busy to come
thanks,
to
Judy.
Lunch.
You're a sweetheart. Thank you.
So you're going to Carnegie Hall, I see.
Yes, I'm going to see Mahler. Mahler's ninth.
Jesus,
I hope Sally likes Mahler.
Of course she'll like it. It's my favorite of all of his. Have some napkins.
Thanks, darling. I've got this great place to bring her to after the concert. It's a little supper joint run by an Italian family. It's very intimate. Got a courtyard, trellis, little fairy lights.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, it is. It's funny, you know, seeing someone who, you know, he's just left a long marriage. I bet it's been a while since she was courted, romanced, so to speak, eh?
Yes, I'm sure.
I'm such a square, Judy, you know that? I'm so old-fashioned. I eat all that stuff up, you know? Music, intimate restaurants, candlelight joints and stuff. I'm from a different era, I think. Amy used to say I should have been born in the 1800s. I think she found it all a bit corny.
Oh, no, it's not at all corny. No, it's very sweet.
It's great, isn't it? I mean, you go in for that stuff too, don't you?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Tonight was fun, Sally, eh?
Yes, it was good. It was good.
And that music was fantastic.
I usually hate Mahler, but it was good. The last movement's too long. I think you should have cut it down. The second movement was good. Well, you know, it began well.
Yeah, then, it started a little bit.
Then it gets sentimental, don't you think?
Yeah.
The conductor fought his way out. Oh, dinner was wonderful. Although I should teach the chef how to make an Alfredo sauce. Didn't quite make it.
Oh, I'm sorry you didn't like it.
Want to?
Yeah, I mean, is it okay?
Coffee.
I'd love to.
Oh, no, I'm only yawning because I'm hyperoxygenating because the car ride just made me a little bit sick.
I'm sorry, Sally. I know I'm not the greatest driver in the world.
No, your driving was fine for the most part. It's not your fault. I shouldn't have had that last margarita. Three's my limit.
I couldn't even finish the second. Oh, this is lovely. It's very homely. English pine. It's the finest.
I prefer French. My decorator screwed me. Anyhow, it's too big for one person. I have to get a place in town. It's funny how your whole life changes. I'm scared here alone,
oh,
you know.
Must be, sure.
There's been robberies.
Yeah, I bet. Do you want to get married again straight away, Sally, or you like being single?
I love being single.
Because, you know, I think certain personalities just need to be married.
I disagree.
Well, that's what they say.
Not me. I thought I did.
I do. I think it's time for me.
Uh-huh. So why have you never got married?
Oh, I don't know. I got close in my 20s once, but it didn't work out.
Is wine okay?
Oh, lovely. Thank you.
Well, I want to be alone for a while at least. I want to have a few experiences. Mm. Then if it happens, great.
Well, I'm sure you'll get what you want. You're a very beautiful woman.
Oh, thank you. I can't go so fast.
I'm sorry.
No, it's just, you know, metabolically, it's not my rhythm.
I understand.
Thank you. I haven't been in a social situation, you know, that's meant anything to me in a very long time.
Well, thank you, Sally. I'm really glad to know you care.
Well, I would not be here with you if I wasn't at least interested in exploring it, you know.
Well, cheers.
Cheers.
Tonight's meant a lot to me, Sally. Thank you.
Lovely. It's nice.
Okay.
What's the rush?
I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm over anxious because I like you a lot.
Oh, dear. Michael, what can I say? I haven't made love, you know, in such a long time.
Uh-huh.
My marriage, I told you, was dead
sure.
for years. I don't know why. Oh, yes, I do. It's the second law of thermodynamics. Sooner or later, everything turns to shit. That's my phrasing, not the Encyclopedia Britannica.
Yeah, it's strange, too, because often one doesn't even see it happening.
I did. That's the part that kills me. I was in town working. Jack was supposed to be out of town on business in Chicago. All of a sudden, by sheer accident,
Hi.
Hey. Hi. How
was
Chicago?
It was good. I mean, it was busy. It was busy. I mean, the old guy doesn't want to settle. He's a tough old bird, boy, Lorenz.
I couldn't bring it up. I was so hurt. I was so full of rage and scared. For weeks, you know, I waited for him to say he'd met someone, but he never did. And although I was always suspicious, I never found another incident. So I chose to overlook it. And I hoped it would go away.
but it didn't. Because I began thinking of getting rid of him and being single. And things just got worse between us. We put up bigger and bigger fronts. Now I'm single. And I realize I'm one of those people who needs to be married.
Hey! Hey!
Oh.
Come here!
Hi!
Where are you going?
I'm just going home.
Come on, I'll give you a lift.
Oh, great!
Come on. I have a surprise for you.
What?
I don't know if you think it's such a surprise. I'm gonna let you read my novel. To really go easy on it because.
Oh, of course.
You know. So, you want to come up?
Now?
Come on, yeah, meet my parents. They're so in love with you. Don't you want to see how I live?
Richard, what are you doing here?
So, this is why I don't see you anymore, huh?
What are you talking about? You're mistaken.
I'm mistaken. I just want to see what he looked like.
No.
You know something? You're not what I thought you'd look like.
Yeah, because this isn't even my boyfriend. He's
oh,
my
really?
Yeah, he's my professor.
Your
from
professor?
Yes.
This is your professor.
I'm Professor Gabriel Roth.
Ah, nice to meet you. Yeah.
Columbia.
Oh, stop.
Columbia.
Yeah.
Barnard.
Yeah.
How interested Barnard. Are you? Come on.
Excuse me, I want to ask you something, Professor. Do you seduce all your students?
Stop
Listen,
it.
Listen, I don't know what this is about. I was just taking her upstairs. So
okay,
I see.
Yeah, just go, please.
Really?
I don't even know why you're here. What are you doing
because
here?
You led me on.
I did not lead you on. I told you from day one
Tell
I didn't want
Tell me something. When
marry.
You have her in your arms, what
oh,
did she say to
stop
you?
Stop it.
I don't
that's
know what to
so,
say.
Why
I
ought
to take you apart.
Like, that's
we
ridiculous.
Go.
You're acting like a 15-year-old. I'm sorry, okay? We
you're
were
sorry.
Never, yeah, we were never
what
meant
What do you think
be.
I am?
I don't know. I just know you're
why
going
don't you
through
just
one
go
of
in,
your phases.
Why don't you just go in?
What? I'm trying to help you out here. Just, all right, fine.
Getting cold.
I'm sorry. This is my mother, and this is Professor
it
Gabe Roth.
It is such an immense pleasure to meet you.
That's my father.
Oh. It is an honor, sir.
How do you do?
Now, what can we get you?
I mean, nothing. I'm fine. It's just a sedative if you have one. Who is that character downstairs?
Oh, I'll tell you about it later.
Oh.
It's so sunny all of a sudden.
Yeah, well,
yeah, we're tremendous fans of yours. We wish you'd still write those funny short, funny, sad you. Stories that you wrote.
Oh, sure.
Just.
So what were you going to tell me about that guy downstairs? Who is this?
Okay. I better start from the beginning then if I'm going to tell you. My father, he had this colleague. It was his business partner. And,
this guy was your father's business partner?
No. This is why I have to tell you way in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
It leads up to him.
Mm-hmm.
And this, my father's business partner, he'd come by to the house fairly often, right? And one day, he told me that he was in love with me, right? And I was very flattered, to say the least. He was real bright and single. And we started having this affair. And naturally, we told nobody. So now I have this friend, Jane. And her parents, they were divorced. Her father, Jerry, developed this mad crush over me, right? And before long, I was seeing both these men. And instead of being happy, I was just miserable. And I couldn't get my feelings straight. And so I went to an analyst. I tried for a few months to work things out, and then one day my analyst said that he was going to stop treating me because he felt it wasn't the thing to do since he was falling in love with me. I was taken with him. I mean, you can imagine he's quite brilliant, and I started seeing him. And I did. I broke off from the other two. But something inside me told me that he couldn't be a very stable person, I mean, let alone a good analyst. So I never really let things get too far with him. Then one night I met Carl, and he was very sweet, and he really came on with me. And I came to my senses, and I said to myself, what am I doing with these older men, you know? So I clean up my act, and I've been dating Carl. But as you can see, Richard is so unstable. He really took it badly.
Oh my God, you've got material for your first novel and the sequel and the an opera by Puccini here. This is incredible.
Yes, but don't you think I'm right? I mean, Carl, he's fun. And what the hell am I doing with the midlife crisis set? I mean, they're all wonderful, rather accomplished men, but in the end, I just felt like I was some kind of symbol of lost youth or unfulfilled dreams. Or am I being too dramatic?
Gabe, now Wayne's birthday party is coming up soon, and we'd love you to come.
Gee, I don't know if it'll be
possible.
No,
he doesn't want to come to my
please,
party.
Please, please, we would love you to come by for a drink, you and your wife, huh?
Mom, he's not going to come to my party.
You know, I think you've been a wonderful influence on Wayne, almost inspirational.
Well, she's great.
And I consider it an honor if you come by for a birthday party.
Just as Gabe gave his manuscript to Rain, Judy also presented some of her writing.
Listen, I finally got around to reading these lovely poems.
You can be completely honest.
I am.
You know, it's just a hobby.
I was moved. They're so full of feeling. Honestly.
Really?
What does your husband say?
Oh, I know. I'd never show them to him.
What?
He'd be much too critical. You know, he has very high standards. He'd be right, too.
No, listen. The two you wrote about New England? Oh.
There's a little graveyard on Martha's Vineyard where I'd love to be buried.
I know it. I used to say to Amy,
no.
That's the place I choose to. I mean, listen, do you want to have lunch outside today?
Sure, I'd love to.
That's so nice, you know, we could...
Gosh, are you soaked?
No, I'm not so bad. What do we do?
Oh, I think just my coat.
Yes,
is it?
Thank you, Anne. Thank you. Oh, thank you. That was fun, wasn't it?
Yes. My hair's a mess.
Listen, Judy, can I speak frankly to you?
Sure.
Thank you for introducing me to Sally.
Oh, yeah.
I think I'm in love with her.
Gee, that was quick.
I mean, not that she shares my feelings, or if she ever will, you know.
Well, she hasn't been single that long.
Yeah, I realize that, but it's like I finally met someone I care about. I'm like, I'm waiting for the other shoe to fall.
Well, you probably had, you know, you're just a little gun shy from maybe some bad experiences.
Yeah. Is she as terrific as she seems?
She is. She's wonderful. She's honest and decent, and I can't say enough good things about her.
Well, thank you, Judy. You know how much I respect your opinion.
Listen, do you mind if I just, I'm just feeling a little funny. It's probably that run down the block,
you
know?
We're
fine.
I don't know why I introduced Sally to Michael. Why did I push them together like that when obviously I had feelings for him myself? So, you know, I was just very confused. I didn't know what I wanted.
You look good. You don't get any older. You have to work out, huh?
You know, since Sally and I broke up, I'm single. I gotta watch it.
I saw Sally the other night. She's dating some guy. She introduced us. Seemed nice. Nice looking. Claire can tell you.
Yeah, I think that, what was he? He's an editor.
So what's the deal? I mean, are they seeing one another or what?
No, I don't. We don't know.
I'm drunk, so don't hold me responsible. But Jack, you gave up a great one when you gave up Sally.
Ken, he's having a good time tonight.
He's right. I know. Look, we were together a lot of years. She's a great lady. I know.
I mean, not to worry. She'll be all right. This guy, Michael something, seemed fine.
Michael?
Ken, What? Don't tell me I'm out of line. You're okay, right? That blonde girl, Samantha, Sam, she should be in the Olympics.
Hey, what do you think? I mean, are they serious about each other?
No, we don't know.
Say she's serious? What did she say?
Jack, we didn't talk, but for a few minutes we just had a...
She looked great. Has she had face work?
We got
face work, huh?
We have to go. It was good to see you. Let's go home.
Where is Sam?
We're going to go home.
If astrology were true,
it is totally, totally, totally provable, you know?
Provable how? From gypsies?
It is totally logical, right? You know, why wouldn't the position of the planets have an influence on our personality?
Do you know who believes this is my babysitter?
There is... They know, right? They know there is more crime during the full moon, right?
Well, who knows?
Well, you know, it's like who? It's like the universe knows this stuff. I mean, you guys, you're all so smart, but it's like you just don't get the fundamental basics.
I would love to get you together with my babysitter.
Well, I would love to meet her.
She doesn't know anyone in New York. You know, she's been with me 2 months. Her phone is
fabulous. You know, because
my ex-wife was a great.
Well, you should listen to your wife. Hey, you know, what can I tell you? I'm just making a point here now, because you know. The positions of the planets, it's like it is crucial to your life, you know? I can't stress this strongly enough, you know? And your body. But I'm totally logical. I mean, I would not put a Sagittarius belief.
Sam,
right?
We gotta go. Come on. Come on.
What?
We're just getting started.
I'm really nice,
come on. Come on.
It's early.
Later.
Well,
we'll see you guys. Come on.
It was really nice meeting you.
Jesus Christ. If you don't know what the hell you're talking about, why don't you try not talking?
They don't know what they're talking about.
They don't know what they're talking about. You feel so goddamn obligated to make conversation all the time. How about listening?
That would be a
novel idea for you.
You are so rude, Jack. I can't believe you just did that to me.
That's right. You're the expert.
Embarrassing. That is the most.
Come on, let's go.
Embarrassing.
Come on, let's get out of here before you make it any worse. Sick. Shit, all the time about astrology. It's so stupid. I told you.
Stupid about it.
Yeah, it is. I'm so sick of listening to your crap about soybeans and Zen foods and the fucking zodiac.
Leave me alone.
In the car.
No.
Hey,
look,
get in the car.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Hey, listen to me. You want to embarrass me in front of my friends? They're trying to make an intellectual conversation. You're sitting here jerking off about the tofu and crystals or something.
Well, believe me, then that just stupid. There's nothing intellectual
get
about
in the car,
them.
Will you?
No,
come on.
Not
come
going.
On. Yes,
sorry.
You are.
No,
shut up.
No!
Shut your mouth, will you? What are you crazy?
You want to embarrass you?
Get? You want to embarrass me? Are you coming with me or not?
No! I hate you and your stupid fucking asshole friends!
Get in the car. Get your ass in the car right now. Get in the car. I don't know where it is. It doesn't matter where it is. Here, get in the car. God damn, I must have been out of my mind. Crazy. Totally crazy.
You're too drunk to drive.
Oh, gosh. I'm not drunk. Just shut up and let's go. Right,
shut
up! God damn it.
Look what you've done now. Just let me out of here.
No.
Let me out of here. Get me out of here. Will you just stop?
I'm not stuck. Get in the car. What are you trying to be cute?
No!
Get in the
car. No!
Oh, I don't believe
you. No! Help!
What am I doing? Get in the car, you infant! Get in the fucking car! Right.
Why were you able to have an orgasm with Michael and not with your husband?
I didn't. I was trying very hard to go with it, but I was tense. I came close.
What makes it so difficult for you?
My mind just gets racing with thoughts. You'd laugh if I told you. I get so mentally hyperactive.
Like what?
I thought that I liked what Michael was doing to me, and it felt different from Jack. More gentle and more exciting. And I thought how different Michael was from Jack, how much deeper his vision of life was. And I thought Michael was a hedgehog and Jack was a fox. And then I thought Judy was a fox and Gabe was a hedgehog. And I thought about all the people I knew, and which were hedgehogs, and which were foxes. Al Simon, a friend, was a hedgehog, and his wife Jenny was a hedgehog,
And Cindy Salkind was a fox. And Lou Petrino was a hedgehog.
I had the impression that at times you weren't quite into it.
Oh, no. I mean, you know, I told you the problems I had with Jack, but... Mm-hmm. No, it was wonderful.
Oh, God, I've heard your feelings, right?
I don't want you to get the wrong impression. I loved it.
Me too.
I used to get really excited when we first got married. Then somewhere along the line, it slipped away.
It's okay.
What? That I'm not responsive?
We had a really nice experience.
Yes. But we had two separate nice experiences.
Okay, but they were nice.
They were separate.
I'm beginning to see why your husband got a bit crazy.
Very funny.
Oh, come on, Sally. You hungry?
He said, trying to change the subject.
Oh, stop it. What was that?
There's been a series of burglaries.
Have you got the alarm on?
No.
Call the police. Call the police. No. I'll take a look. Who are you? Who are you?
Jack! My God!
You changed the lock on my own goddamn house. Who's this? Who's this?
This is my husband. It's none of your business. Please
none of my
leave
business.
Right now.
I don't want to leave.
Leave right now.
All right. Am I all right?
You all right, pal?
What the hell? Who are you?
Hey.
Is he living here?
Don't
What's
get
the
upset.
Deal? Don't get upset.
Don't get
What's
upset.
He doing? Fucking you in our bed?
Hey,
that's the deal.
No.
Don't get. Let's
hey,
not
Mike,
get ugly.
It's my house.
Let's not get ugly. It's my house.
No, I can talk to him. Really, please go upstairs. Please.
Where's he going?
Michael.
Now? There.
Yes, if I know. If
just
I'm sure.
You're going up to our bed. Is that the deal?
It's not our bed, Jack. Anymore. No. Now listen.
What
you need some black coffee. I'm gonna make it. Then just you know go.
Sally, listen. I want to come back.
Oh,
please. Oh man, my life is such a fucking mess.
Jack, this is not the time and place to discuss this. Please
this is not
go.
The place. What are you?
This
no,
is my
no,
house. Hey, this is my no, fucking
it's
house.
My fucking house. My house. Now.
I want to start over again.
Okay? No, that's not possible. Too much has happened.
Oh God.
Sally, can I help?
Oh please,
hey,
no, Michael. Lost?
What is it
do
with
you
him?
Mind?
What is he, the guardian here or something?
This
is
something.
Ridiculous.
No, I can handle this.
Oh man.
I don't believe this. I don't believe it.
Well, don't. You don't have to believe it. Go.
You listen. Look at. This was not all my fault, you know. Okay, it takes two of
I
us.
Never
I never mean,
said
both of us
it was all
up.
Your fault.
You don't know how hard you are to live
oh,
with.
Please.
You would just break
I
my back all the time.
Somewhere.
You, that's
yes,
it. Perfect. See,
have.
She's got an answer to everything. Everything.
Well, what do you want me to say? You know, our marriage was full of problems. Yes, I know that. You know, some were my fault, some were yours. But you
go
lied
ahead.
To me, you
hey.
Deceived me, you cheated on me.
Why don't you
I
just
know.
Run upstairs
God,
and tell him
loving
there's,
each
a,
other.
There's a stranger in the
he
house.
He knows, he knows.
He knows. Well, that's perfect, too. Hey, you show me one couple that doesn't have problems, you know. It's not that unusual. Everybody, it's tough. Everybody has a tough time, you know.
What happened to the one you moved in with?
That's bullshit. It's total bullshit.
Well, I met someone I like.
What? You what?
I met someone I like.
What about all the years we had together?
Well, you know, you had no problem wiping them out when it suited you.
But I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what else to do. I didn't know what to
oh,
do.
Oh, no, no, I can't discuss this now. Please, go. You know, you'll feel better tomorrow.
I'm going to feel like shit tomorrow. That's what I'm going to feel like.
Oh, shit.
Hi, I need to speak to Jack.
How long are you just going to leave me out there, right?
I told you,
I have never been treated like this in my life before.
It's really a perfect how you ruin a life.
Well, then go see a psychiatrist.
God, I need to see a shrink. Please.
Hey, come on in. Come on in. Why don't you join us? This is about all of us, you know. We don't have any secrets.
Well, that's bullshit. We have nothing but secrets.
What do you mean?
I never met a Scorpio who wasn't secret.
Will you stop with that shit?
You are Scorpio. I'm going to bed. Get out. Both of you, get out.
What's the big deal? I mean, so I did a couple of things wrong. I yelled. I misbehaved. Does it have to be irreversible?
The heart raged and demanded, grew melancholy and confused, and toward what end? To articulate what nitwit strategy? Procreation? It told him something, this business of how mind-boggling numbers of sperm competed for a single egg. It was not the other way around. Of course men would make love at any time and place with any number of women, including total strangers, while females were more selective. They were in each case catering to the demands of only one small egg, while each male had millions and millions of frantic sperms screaming wildly, "Let us out, please, let us out, now." It was like those desperate ads in the personals column, with a dozen requirements, and if they were not enough, there was added, "Must be a non-smoker." Feldman longed to meet a woman who attracted him physically and had the following personality: a quick sense of humor equal to his, a love of sports equal to his, a love of classical music equal to his, with a particular fondness for Bach and balmy climates. In short, he wanted himself, but as a pretty woman. Pepkin married and raised a family. He led a warm domestic life, placid but dull. Knapp was a swinger. He eschewed nuptial ties and bedded 5 different women a week. Students, housewives, nurses, actresses, a doctor, a salesgirl, you name it, it held Knapp between its legs. Pepkin, from the calm of his fidelity, envied Knapp. Knapp, lonely beyond belief, envied Pepkin. What happened after the honeymoon was over? Did desire really grow with the years, or did familiarity cause partners to long for other lovers? Was the notion of ever-deepening romance a myth we had grown up on, along with simultaneous orgasm? The only time Rifkin and his wife experienced a simultaneous orgasm was when the judge handed them their divorce. Maybe in the end, the idea was not to expect too much out of life.
So the book was wonderful. It was entertaining and imaginative and moving.
You don't have to say this. You can be critical.
And oh, I know, of course. It was just
really?
All the suffering and how you make it so funny, you know, and all the little lost souls running around.
That's funny, you know, because I've had so much trouble with this book, I can't tell you.
Have you let anybody else read it?
Oh, well, not exactly, you know. Listen, I'm so thrilled that you feel this way. I can't tell you how encouraged I am. It means so much to me, really. You know, your feelings about it are really, you know, of course, you are a sucker for my work, so I shouldn't get too excited.
Oh, no, that's not true. I mean, I'm objective. And, I mean, yes, I do love the way you write and everything. I had some criticisms, but overall, the thing was just...
Well, sure, you must have had criticisms, obviously. You know, what were they?
Nothing serious. I mean, the whole thing was just a delight. Yeah?
Really? Well, you know, I can't tell you. I've had such a love-hate relationship with this book.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
What's the matter?
Oh, I think I left the thing in the cab.
You're kidding. In a taxi cab?
Oh, my God.
Are you
I'm
sure?
Cry. And I can't believe I did this to you. Okay, he was Indian. The driver
you
was
left
Indian.
In an Indian's uh-huh. cab?
No, he was Armenian. I can't believe this.
That was
this.
An only copy.
I know,
you
wait.
You must be joking.
Was it Hargopian? Could that be possible?
Hargopian, yes. Mr. Hargopian or Swami Hargopian or what? I mean... I was totally crushed. I wanted to die. This was the worst thing that happened.
But you put up a false front for her.
Right, I had to, because the poor girl was wrecked. I mean, what was I going to do? I was trying to bail her out.
So this book was very meaningful to you, despite all your carrying on about how you hated it.
I guess so.
And the young woman, Rain.
her approbation was very significant to me. I mean, it was...
Well, why was her praise and encouragement for your work so pleasing? Judy, your own wife, had liked it very much, and you gave her such a hard time.
I don't know, but there was some kind of rapport I felt here that... So it was meaningful to me.
Hey! Hey, somebody find your envelope! Waiting at the house now. Come here.
It's so Freudian.
What is?
Oh, the whole thing of leaving the novel in the cab and everything.
Oh, no, don't be silly. You know, it could happen to anybody. You misplaced it for a moment.
No, I think maybe it meant something.
Like what?
Well, I don't know. I think maybe, I mean, I could have been threatened.
Threatened by my book?
Yeah. That's I'm very competitive by nature.
That's absurd.
Why? Because I'm a young female?
No, don't get angry. Because I'm in your corner. I'm your biggest fan.
Yeah. I just think that maybe I could have been threatened by certain things in the book.
Like what? You know.
Some of the attitudes towards women and your ideas on life.
You told me you love the book.
I do. I do love it. Yeah.
What were your criticisms?
Nothing.
No, tell me what your criticisms were.
I was a little disappointed, I guess, with some of your attitudes.
Like what? What attitudes? With what?
The way your people just casually have affairs like that, that's...
Well, the book doesn't condone affairs. You know, I'm exaggerating for comic purposes.
Yeah. I mean, but are our choices really between chronic dissatisfaction and suburban drudgery?
No, but, you know, that's how I'm deliberately distorting it, you know, because I'm trying to show how hard it is to be married. And,
well, you have to be careful not to trivialize with things like that.
Jesus, I hope I haven't.
Well, the way your lead character views women, it's so retrograde, it's so shallow, you know?
What are you talking about? You told me it was a great book.
Yeah, it's wonderful. And I never said great. I said it's brilliant and it's alive. And, you know, that's not what we're not arguing about, whether it's brilliant or not. I'm, you know, Triumph of the Will, it was a great movie, but you despise the ideas behind it.
What are you saying now, that you despise my ideas?
No, I don't despise them. That example was... Okay. Isn't it beneath you as a mature thinker? I mean, to allow your lead character to waste so much of this emotional energy obsessing over this psychotic relationship with a woman that you fantasize as powerfully sexual and inspired when, in fact, she was pitifully sick.
Look, let's stop this right now, because I don't need a lecture on maturity or writing from a 20-year-old twit. You asked me if you could read my book. I said okay. You told me that you loved it.
And I do.
And then you leave the fucking thing in a taxi cab, and you're weeping, and I'm consoling you, and suddenly you turn on me.
Okay. I must have hit a nerve with you.
Well, yeah, Boy, I'd hate to be your boyfriend. He must go through hell.
Well, I'm worth it.
Oh, did you have trouble finding the house?
No, no, none at all.
Oh, I mean,
it was very easy. Thank you so much.
I'm so glad you found it. I can't tell you what this means to me.
This is so nice of you.
It's all right.
What did you do?
Right.
You just found it in the cab?
Yeah, I jumped in the cab and I wound up sitting on it. You know, I just opened the door and there's this envelope. So
it's so nice. Let me
go. Oh, okay.
I want to.
No, it's okay.
No, really, I can't.
Please, I want you guys to stay for coffee. I won't take no for an answer.
She won't take no for an answer.
She won't. Trust me.
It's a big occasion for us.
Good.
Great.
A cup of coffee.
Listen, I'm sorry for everything.
Excuse me, Mr. Roth, if you don't mind my saying, you got a beautiful daughter yourself.
Yes, I admit it. Our argument in the cab was, I found attractive, and it attracted me to her in some way. You know, that she was not just a sort of a passive little worshipful pupil or something that, you know, something in me sensed that, not that I was going to do anything about it, I certainly wasn't, though I had, you know, certain daydreams about it.
Less than 2 weeks later, Jack and Sally got back together. This turn of events was celebrated over dinner with Judy and Gabe.
Listen, you know, you just can't wipe out years of closeness. I mean, you think you can. You don't see the roots, but boy, they're there.
I think some people are just not constituted to be single.
Hey, look, everybody screws up, you know? Nobody's perfect. The question is, do you learn from it? What do you do then? You know?
I think the true test of a relationship is how you weather crisis. Yes?
Yeah. Everybody looks great, you know, when everything's going smoothly.
It's great. If you can be that mature, it's great.
It's not that. It's just, I think you start finally thinking about priorities. It's the question of priorities.
Yeah, I mean, how long can you discuss physical fitness in the Zodiac?
Hey, this Michael character was no bargain.
Oh,
come on.
How was Michael?
I don't know. He was sick. He called in sick. So I gave him a call, and he did sound very terrible, but I don't know, he had a cold.
He's so sweet. I guess I really pull the rug out from under him. Although, you know, his real crush is on Judy. No. Not to offend you, Gabe.
I'm not. I love it when somebody thinks highly of Judy.
Gabe needs confirmation of his feelings, especially when it comes to me.
Yeah, it's a terrible thing to
true.
Say.
No, really. I'd watch it if I were you, Gabe.
Excuse me.
He always talks about Judy in hushed tones. I think those poems you wrote impressed him.
Hey, come on. Here's to a good marriage, huh? Finally, the best two people can hope for.
Absolutely.
I didn't know you were fooling around with poetry.
I didn't think you'd be interested.
Well, why not?
Because. I tell you something, I'd be embarrassed to show you my stuff.
Why?
Because you're so hard on everything.
I am not. What
are you
talking about?
You are, too. You're very, very judgmental.
I'm not judgmental. I like poetry. I like, you know, I'm crazy about Shakespeare and Byron and T.S. Eliot.
Oh,
you know,
well, my stuff isn't quite that good yet.
Well, I would have given you an objective evaluation.
I want an objective evaluation, you know? I'd like something a little more supportive, a little more generous.
You like from that character in your office?
He's not a character.
Are you in love with him?
No. What, because I show him a few poems? I saw Dr. Ritchie today.
Oh, where?
I went back into psychotherapy.
Jesus, you're kidding. You don't need psychotherapy, and certainly not with her.
You're just threatened by her because she's postmodern.
Listen, anyone who writes a paper suggesting the Sabine women had it coming to them...
That's not it.
Jesus. I do not flirt.
Don't tell me you don't flirt because I've seen you do it at parties. You put on a whole other personality.
Oh, you're crazy.
Of course you do. You get all soulful and pretend to want things that you really can't stand.
Like what? What are you talking
about?
Like
moving to Europe. That's just a flirting technique. You couldn't survive off the island of Manhattan for more than 48 hours.
Let me tell you, you're the one that misrepresented herself when we got married.
What do you
I've
mean
been honest
by that?
All
like
along.
What?
Like what? Like you had one child and then, you know, you didn't want
yes,
any more? That was
the way
plenty?
I felt then. People change. I'm not the same person I was all those years ago.
Well, that's why relationships go sour.
Yeah, you hate change.
Sure, I hate change equals death.
What kind of bullshit? Death? That's just a bullshit line. Maybe you fool your 20-year-old students into thinking that's some kind of an insight or something, but it means nothing. Change is what life is made of. Change, if you don't change, you don't grow. You just shrivel up.
I don't want to make love. You always get sexual at the oddest times.
What are you so tense about?
You use sex to express every emotion except love.
You were attracted to me because in some way, and I never figured out how, but in some way, I reminded you of Harriet. But then I disappointed you because I was too normal.
I was attracted to you because you were solid and decent and you were not crazy.
Yeah, and you found that too boring.
No, as it turns out, you're in your own quiet way. You're as crazy as Harriet was.
See, I did remind you of Harriet.
No, look, my sixth sense told me, some kind of sixth sense said that you were not stable. But you, on the surface, you are. But now that we're having all kinds of problems, you're not stable. You were on the surface, but not really. This whole thing is becoming very clear to me.
we both couldn't sleep one night. Remember when we found the movie of Wild Strawberries on the cable station and we stayed up all night watching it? Remember that? That was such a great, for some reason, a great moment for me. When we were going to the faculty dinner, and I'll never forget this, we were on Fifth Avenue when it was just an icy black night. We were walking downtown. Remember that? And then suddenly we decided not to go to the dinner. We just had the hell with it. And it was just such a beautiful night. We walked into Central Park. It was so snowy that night and everything. You could see every star. It was so beautiful in that black dress, really.
Mm. Don't do that.
Why not?
Because it's over and we both know it.
Do we?
Yeah, you know, all that stuff that... Those memories, they're just memories. They're from years gone by. They're just isolated moments, you know? They don't tell the whole story.
Several days later, Gabe moved out of his apartment and into a hotel.
No, I wasn't being completely honest with Gabe, because I didn't want to hurt him, but I did know what I wanted. I was in love with Michael, and I wanted to be free to pursue that and not have to lie or cheat or sneak around or anything.
How can I be, you know, 100% honest with Judy? I felt that I loved her, and I I didn't want to hurt her. And so what am I gonna say? That I feel myself becoming infatuated with a 20-year-old girl, and that, that I see myself sleepwalking into a mess, and I've learned nothing over the years?
Then why didn't you stop yourself?
There was something in my marriage that I craved that I was not getting, and Rain, there was a certain excitement there for me.
Rain had a boyfriend.
I know. Believe me, everything about it was wrong. I know. But, that did not deter me. I mean, that if anything, maybe as usual, there was something interesting.
So what is it? You have a self-destructive streak?
You know, I don't know. My heart does not know from logic. You know, it just...
I'll give myself one. Oh.
Get it. Hello? Oh, Michael, please. Look, I can't keep discussing this. I mean, it was a decision I felt I should make. No, I wanted to. I'm sorry. Look, I can't... I said sorry many times now. I can't keep discussing this. No, I don't want to have a drink. I have to go. Well, you make it hard. I have to go.
A week or two passed, and Judy helped Michael get over the loss of Sally.
Here we go.
Oh, heavens, Judy.
Pretty good, huh?
That's mine. Where's yours? I am so hungry. Okay. It's not true. Shall I be mum? Cheers.
Cheers.
That's a real treat today. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Where's your wife? Did she come?
Oh, no, to tell you the truth, we're not together anymore.
You writers.
Happy birthday!
Hi, how are you doing?
Did you meet that woman, Jessica? Her daughter and I used to be best friends.
No, I met Angela.
Oh, yeah, right.
Did you see that?
What?
Incredible. This time of year, it's so beautiful. Mm-hmm.
Wow. Oh, I love storms.
It's great to look at it. The television said we were supposed to get the tail end of that hurricane off Carolina.
It's really coming down heavy now.
Oh, it's very fitting. I was born during a hurricane. I really love it.
It's dangerous.
She looks so lovely, doesn't
she? Great time. My God, she's 21. You know, it's absolutely incredible. Our little Rainer, huh?
I'm going to be 55.
You know, it's our 25th wedding anniversary in June.
Don't worry. Look, we got some light in here. I know I paid that bill. Hey, take some of these pants out.
Actually, you better just give you
Yes, I know I have a flashlight. Oh, it's just my luck and my own birthday. It goes black.
Hey, you look very, very pretty in the Cadillac.
Oh, God, did you see the lightning flashes?
It's great.
And the wind is supposed to get worse. I just don't know how everybody's going to get home now.
Happy birthday. I've been carrying this around all night. I didn't want to give it to you in another room because I thought that, you know, people might think it was funny or something. It could be misconstrued, so I'm hiding it under my jacket for...
Oh, God, that's lovely. That was so pretty.
Oh, happy birthday.
Why would it be misconstrued?
I don't know. It just looks funny, I think, because you have a boyfriend and I give you this very romantic music box. And, you know, I just wouldn't want anyone to get the wrong idea.
It didn't look funny at all. It's beautiful. You know what I really like?
What?
A nice birthday kiss.
You want a birthday kiss?
Yeah.
Happy birthday.
That's
oh,
all?
I'm really drunk. This is not funny. What? Why? What do you mean that's all? That's a birthday kiss. What do you want me to do? Bend you back and stick my tongue down your throat to your shoe tops?
No. Come on, you know what I mean. Don't you?
I can't give you a birthday kiss. You're nuts. You got a boyfriend in the other room.
I know. It's not serious. It isn't serious.
Listen, it's insane. I can't even have this conversation. Not that I haven't thought about it. I have, but it's just too crazy.
That's so disappointing.
Why is it disappointing? You got a boyfriend.
Because it's, you couldn't ask for a more romantic moment. I mean, it's my 21st birthday, and we're in the middle of a storm, and the lights are out, and there's the wind and rain sweeping the New York skyline.
Oh, Jesus, don't do this. Why do I
it's
hear...
It's magical.
$50,000 worth of psychotherapy dialing
911. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I've had a little too much to drink, too.
Me, too. I haven't...
Yeah. I'm just...
So what do you want a kiss? I mean, you want a real kiss?
Yeah.
You want an actual professional kiss, right?
Yes.
Both lips, upper and lower, simultaneously?
Yeah, I've been really thinking about it. I gotta tell you.
Come here. All I could think of was, I hope that lightning can't come into a penthouse, because I'd never been in one before, and it was tumultuous out there. It was crashing all around, and, you know, the scene had to be, it just cried out dramatically to be played. I mean, she was adorable. I wanted to kiss her, and, you know, it was pouring rain, but there was lightning bouncing around the terrace, and I figured any second it's going to come right through the glass or come right into the apartment, and that I would die.
Judy, leave me be. I do not want to spend Sunday together because I need some time alone.
So be alone. I'm certainly not pushing you.
Yes, yes, you are. And that quiet, steady way of yours. You're always there for me. Supportive is your word. Understanding. God, stop being so bloody well understanding. Well,
me.
I'm sorry, right? I still think a lot about Sally. I still have feelings for her. Feelings I don't think I could ever have for you. Oh, God. Where are you going? Oh, God. Judy. Judy, I'm sorry. I never want to see you again, okay?
Oh,
don't say that, Judy. I need you.
It's good to know how you really feel.
But I don't feel that way. I was just upset, darling.
You are
please.
So selfish and
I am,
self-centered.
I know. Don't give up on me. I didn't mean those things. I said them because I'm confused. I'm upset. Lord, I never want to hurt you again in my life.
Bullshit.
It's not bullshit. I don't deserve you. I'm sorry. Please.
Did you close all the windows?
Yeah, I was just thinking that. You know, it's a good thing we fixed that leak in the den. We'd be swimming now.
It's crazy, but after all these years, I'm still scared of thunder.
any loud noise.
It would have been absolutely nuts to use those theater tickets, you know that? We'd have been swerving all over the road. Damn it. Can we stay home?
I'm glad we stayed home.
Me too.
You know, when we were separated, this is exactly the kind of night that would have terrified me. And I was scared enough sleeping alone.
You know, sometimes you can be a lot more alone when you're with somebody.
Do you think we should have given those other tickets to Gabe or Judy? I mean, we did buy them for them.
Yeah, I know, but the situation's completely different now.
A year and a half later, much had occurred. Judy was divorced and married to Michael.
So, are you happy?
Yes. I think things have gone pretty smoothly. Michael puts up with my idiosyncrasies.
No. It's you. It's he that puts up with mine.
Look, I told you, she's passive-aggressive. Somehow she gets what she wants. She wanted me. She wanted Gabe. She wanted the job at the magazine. Out of her marriages. She wants Michael.
I disagree. No, when Sally went back to her husband, I made a big play for Judy. I mean, not at first, but when I decided, I went after her.
Yeah, gee, I hope I didn't push. You know, I wanted it to work, it's true.
We're doing fine. We really are. We're doing good. We've learned to tolerate one another's problems more, I think, don't you?
And, well, I've learned anyway that love is not about passion and romance necessarily. It's also about companionship and, you know, it's like a buffer against loneliness, I think.
That stuff is really important. Really, you know, somebody to grow old with. Think what the thing that's so tough that kills most people is just unreal expectations.
What about things that can't be talked about? Like sexual problems, for instance.
That's
unresolved.
Unresolved.
Well, there's some things you can't solve, and then you have to live with it. You construct some kind of patchwork thing, and but sometimes they flare up.
They do, and when that happens, they do. They just it kind of gets tough when that happens. They're going to do it.
But you learn to deal with the problem, and then you push it back down under the rug.
And, you know, and it works. That's the weird thing. It works okay. It's not bad.
I mean, you can't force yourself to conform to some abstract vision of love or you know, marriage. It's, every situation's different.
Whatever works is the deal. I mean, you know, everything is going to be different. Ours is one way, somebody else another way.
You know, it's funny. Last year, when we were at Gabe and Judy's that night, when we announced so flippantly we were splitting, I wasn't feeling that confident inside.
I sure as hell wasn't either. Stupid.
I remember envying them so, thinking they were so lucky. They had such a great marriage.
Yeah, it's ironic that, you know, we're together and they aren't.
Yeah.
Weird.
I experienced a very romantic moment with Rain at her 21st birthday party. And I could feel the old pull coming back, you know, the old attraction coming back. It's some feelings that I sensed from the past in my life. It was very vivid to me. That was a great moment there, but I don't really think that we should follow up on it.
Oh, what do you mean?
Well, you know, I just, you know, if things were, you know, were different, if I was younger, or, you know, if you were older, or anything different, but I just, somehow I just feel I know how this is going to come out.
You sure?
I am. You know, I really am.
Okay.
And I left and I walked out into the pouring rain. You know, first I, you know, I just headed instinctively back to my apartment. Because, you know, I wanted to hold Judy and kiss her and say things to her. And, you know, and then I realized that, you know, I really blew it.
So what's your life like now?
You know, I'm out of the race at the moment. I don't want to get involved with anybody. I don't want to hurt anyone. I don't want to get hurt. I don't mind, you know, living by myself and working. It's temporary. I mean, the feelings will pass, and then I'll have the urge to get back into the swing of things. And, you know, that seems to be how it goes. But as I say, it's, you know, I'm writing. I'm working on a novel, a new novel, not the old one anymore. And, you know, it's fine, absolutely fine.
Is it different?
My novel? Yes, it's less confessional, more political. Can I go? Is this over?